What's up, everyone? How are everyone's doing? Sorry, I haven't posted a new video for a while because I've been busy for the last month to finishing my PhD dissertation. So I just defend my PhD last week. So now I have more time to make a video for you guys. So in this video, we'll quickly learn how to apply the rule of three in structure your presentation as well as to use it in designing your PowerPoint. So the first and the most important way to use this rule of three is to answer the three most important questions of any scientific research. Start with why you do this research, and then move on to how you plan to do it. And finally, you go to explain what you found from your research. So always start with why. Start with why you do this research. Why should people care? Like, just you need to emphasize the importance, the significance of your research. And then from there, when you hook the audience about the importance of your research, we move in to how you plan to solve this problem of that is very important. And then you finally, you tell them what you found in your experiment. And the second way you can apply this rule of three is to limit your message to three messages per slide or three take-home messages per presentation. So never exceed this three message, because people cannot remember more than three messages you want to deliver. So I will go deeper into that in later. And also in the designing part, you can apply the rule of three in the ratio of 3-to-1 ratio. If you are into photography or to designing, you probably know about rule of third or the golden ratio. And the last way to apply the rule of three is to limit to three main colors in your design, which I talk about in the color lessons. So now let's go in and dive in deeper about how to apply rule of three in your PowerPoint presentation to improve your structure of your presentation as well as to improve the designing of your PowerPoint slides. One of my most favorite book is Start With Why by Simon Sinek. So you guys should check out this book. So in this book, he mentioned that this can be applied in your daily life or in your business or also applied in your PowerPoint presentation. So always start with why and mention the significant, the importance of the problem. And you believe that if solving this problem, you can create some change in the world, and the change is needed. And from there, you explain how you plan to do it, how you solve this problem, how do you tackle it, because you believe it's so deep that you can change it. And next part is how you your plan step by step, which is the methodology. And the final circle is what you found from your research. And all of this circle, why, how, and what, is equivalent to the start with the rationale of your research, like introduction. So move into the methodology of your research and end up with the result in the result in discussion that again prove the rationale, the hypothesis that you set out in this research. And moving to the second way to apply this rule of three, so always limit your message to three messages. So three objectives for each research. So I think three objectives is enough. And from here, you can conclude, have three conclusions, like three take-home message. And also apply the 3-second rule in presenting your data, which I talked about in the previous lessons. So basically, you design in such a way that the audience need only less than 3 seconds to understand your point and understand your graph and your presentation. So now I will give an example. I will show the figure and then I will give you 3 seconds and let's see if you can understand what I try to present in this case or not. 1, 2, 3. So you can see 3 seconds pass and then your eye just wander around and your eye don't know where to focus. You can see that this is a very inefficient way of presenting your data. But I saw it a lot in a lot of presentation, and it seems like people just copy the whole data table from their publication and put in the PowerPoint slide and torture the audience. So please don't do this. Use the 3-second rule to filter your slides. So if the slide takes more than 3 seconds to understand, delete it. Simplify it. For example, this one need 1, 2, Yeah, and you already know it talk about methane yield, and one treatment is higher than the other one. So use graph, and more simple graph is better, just to deliver one simple point per slides. So here's a quick example of my PhD dissertation. So I have my experiment, and then from there, I set out three objectives that I want to answer in my dissertation. So these three objectives are interrelated, and they help me to answer the hypothesis and to confirm the hypothesis of my research. So these three objectives are equivalent to three research questions that I want to answer. It's like a three piece of the puzzle that help me to complete the whole image of the research. So you can see using this, you can structure your research and then explain to the audience the way or step by step how you plan to do your research and how it all pieced together into the big picture. So by this way, it helped me a lot in structuralize my presentation and also help the audience to follow my objective and presentation and see how it all pieced together at the end. And in this slide, you can also see the design aspect of applying rule of three. I have three pieces of the puzzle with equal size. Also, each puzzle in different color, and all of my objectives are all color-coded. So everything about the first objective is in orange, everything about the second objective is in blue. So let's move into rule of three. Basically, you divide your screen into three equal portions, and this helps you to arrange your presentation. So in photography, if you put your main object that you want to focus in one of the four circles in the picture over here, you have the better focus and the better ratio of the object to the foreground and the background. And in designing the PowerPoint presentation, now you see that your screen divides into nine small portions. And you can utilize the center portion as your main piece of information. Normally, I will put like a big graph or a chart or a table over here. And if your graph is long, so feel free to use the whole length of your presentation. And be creative and play around with the portion, with the ratio. If you have like some text, you can put the text on the left-hand side and your graph or your table on the right-hand side, or the figure on the right and the description on the left like this. So be creative, and I think use the rule of three, you can portion your presentation more efficiently. The last way to apply is to use three main color. So in the color wheel, if you use the triad color, which are the color from the three opposite sides of the color wheels, like in this figure, or you can have it more evenly of red, blue, and yellow. Or the triad color can also monochromatic, which mean they are the three shades of the same color. So please check the lessons about colors and also the lessons about presenting your data. I talk on more deeply about this. So to conclude this lesson, apply rule of three. You can answer the three most important questions: why, how, and what. Also limit your message to three messages per slide or per presentation. Also, keep the 3-to-1 ratio in your design, and also use the three color scheme. So thank you very much for watching, and I will see you in the next lecture. Thank you.